Hey Ryan, Ricky here from Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. In this video, we're going into three options for sourcing products for dropshipping as you scale, okay? So before we get into it, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Also follow me on Instagram. So in relation to this, as you start to scale and you start getting more consistent orders, you wanna look at some other options that will be a benefit to you. And one of those options is is a private link from your supplier. Okay, this is a very common one that I've done many a times, and it's where you'll probably start first, is if you find a good supplier, try and get them to give you a private link. And why you do that is that one, it means that no one else can see that link. They can't see the sales, sort of hides the product a bit, because it means that people just can't see if this product, it might be a non-saturated product, and they don't see that from the front end. And so you have a private link and you've sold hundreds of them. And so it sort of can hide your winning product, okay? You also get a discount. Most of the time you can ask for a discount. I usually ask for a 10 to 15% discount straight off the bat. There's no reason to not. And as you scale more, just ask for more discounts, okay? Just straight away ask for discounts. The reality is that they're just supplying them from a manufacturer, and they're putting a margin on top of it like we are. Okay, that's just how it works. And all you need to do is you just put it in Dropfight and Oblo, okay? Now, obviously, the only downside of that is that private link will only work with that supplier with that product, okay? The next one is a sourcing agent, okay? So you can find these on Upwork quite easily. So with your sourcing agents, it's really easy to find them on Upwork. Really not that hard at all. All I've done is just four filters, and this is all I really do for anyone I'm trying to find on Upwork, is 1K, they've earned at least 1K, which means they've done something. You can even go, like, there's really not a huge difference, probably better to go 10K. 90% and up success rate, which means people giving feedback, any hourly rate, because you just want to leave that open for now. And obviously at least 1 hour build. For people that are earning 10K, that have earned 10K, they've probably done 100 hours billing, or something similar to that, but just leave it as one. You want it as independent as well. I like having them independent. So you can see here, that's not really specifically it, but you're just gonna have to look through, look at this, these two people here. We can see that this lady here is a top sourcing agent for eBay, Amazon, Alibaba, importation consultants. 100% success rate, he's at 100%. Price difference is $5, one from Philippines. Now, this isn't in any regards being racist, but I tend to get mine from Philippines. But they're really good. You know, you can get plenty in China as well. You can see here that they, like, look at that. That's insane, $12.50. He's not mine, if that's what you're wondering. But you can see I can send more than 8,000 packages worldwide, right? So that's all you need to do there. And you can find a sourcing agent, you know, negotiate. They go and find the product for you. They go and find the best price. They go and find the best shipping. So what that's going to do is you're going to bypass AliExpress. You're actually going to save money on the front end, because, you know, let's say the product's $10, it might come down to $7, $6 or something, right? Because, you know, AliExpress suppliers, they put a markup, of course. They put at least, you know, a 20 to 30% markup for their margins, who knows. So you're bypassing that, okay? It does mean that there's a bit of extra work. The bit of extra work is, I've gone through that. They can ship with USPS and FedEx, mostly USPS or USPS, USP, whatever, I keep forgetting. You actually, in a lot of regards, can get better quality as well, because you go on straight to the manufacturer. So find a really good manufacturer, that's their job. And you just have to work with them on that. The downsides is there's a little bit of extra manual work. You do need to use something like Exportify. Exportify exports your orders, so you can just choose it by the range of the date range, basically being today or something. And you export it as a CSV. Now keep in mind that's gonna export orders, unless all your orders are the exact same product. You're gonna have to do some filtering and just cut out other products. You might have to make multiple CSVs to your supplier so that he or she can go to the manufacturer or manufacturers. There might be multiple, because obviously as you're scanning, you're gonna probably try and find, you should be finding other products that sell well too. And that's pretty much how you do that. You just send that to them, just send it via email, or if you have them on Slack, just get them on Slack. I use Slack. It's just much easier because the files are all there and there's sort of, you know, you've got a history. Then once the orders are fulfilled, then you just use Mass Fulfill, okay? And that's another app. These apps are really cheap on Shopify. They just install in the back end. They're not going to slow down your website, if anyone's wondering. And you use Mass Fulfill to re-import the CSV that the sourcing agent sends to you. And then you just import it and it has the tracking numbers and it'll automatically fulfill it, okay? It's going to pair it up and it's going to fulfill it, okay? So you just have to make sure that it correlates correctly. If your sourcing agent's done it properly, then it should. Just communicate with them and it'll be fine, okay? Now, some sourcing agents, depending on places as well, they might have some specific arrangements as well. And I've heard a number of sourcing agents as well, they just use like Upwork just to get clients and then you go to an external website. If you're comfortable doing that, I try and stick in Upwork, at least beginning to build trust. And you know, it helps them as well. So you can negotiate the price, the shipping, the inventory, okay, and they'll honor those arrangements. So if you are getting 50 orders a day, okay, that's probably where you want to look at this. You're getting 50 orders a day and the product costs $40, you know, that's $2,000, is that right? Yeah. You're charging $40 and the product costs you $20. You're going to need, you know, $1,000 of inventory on hand at all times, right, at least. And so you want to have, you know, 5K worth of inventory, just an arrangement with them that they can go ahead and buy and they'll just fulfill it for you. For the most part, it's very similar to Dropfinding that, but just a little bit different, okay? But that's only if you've got good profit margins, okay? I don't recommend this if you're not doing it, if you're on tight profit margins, because it's going to make it, the main benefits is you're going to save a little bit of money here, but upfront as well. The main downside is that the sourcing agent has to go and find the product from the manufacturers. And as you can see here from their prices, $25 an hour, they can take anywhere from, you know, a couple of hours to multiple hours, just, you know, days worth of hours to find it, okay? So do a bit of research yourself, get comfortable, make sure you know your margins, scale up and then look at that. Lastly, we also have fulfillment centers, okay? Now, I've been looking more and more into this and you know, like on new stores and all that. That's what I plan more to do would be use ShipBob, okay? There's FlowShip, okay? ShipBob is in the US and it ships internationally. FlowShip is China and it ships internationally too. But as I've said, I mainly stick to the big five countries and most of your customers are always from the US, especially because most of our stores are US currency. So that's where you're going to get most of your customers and they have the biggest pockets. So ShipBob is my recommendation. It integrates natively with Shopify. It has extremely fast shipping. Okay. Just, you can't, you know, it's on par with Amazon really. 1 to 2 days. And it's pretty much, I say 1 day fulfillment, but it's actually pretty much same day fulfillment. Okay. So we're looking at a 1 to 3 day turnover max. And I can tell you now, people are really happy with that. That makes all the difference, okay? You can use ShipBob at earlier stages, but it is going to chew into your margins a bit more. Why? Because of you have to pay freight because you are going to have to buy in bulk again, okay? It's like with your sourcing agent, but you're going to have to pay for freight to their fulfillment center. They've got multiple fulfillment centers across the United States. You have to get a quote. And they'll help arrange that for you. They just give you an address and you just go on Alibaba, send it, blah, blah. And then you have your US shipping fees. Okay, so that they're a bit more expensive between the two of that. That's why it doesn't have to be 150 orders. It could even be 50 if you've got good margins and you prefer that. If you're really trying to build a brand in the US, I would recommend that. Again, you want to look at about 5K worth of inventory. You want to have at least 5K worth of inventory, but remember, if you think about it, if you are getting 50 orders a day and the products, you know, you're getting 50 a day and the product costs you $20, you know, you're going to quickly chew up through that, okay? So that's why you need to have a bit of extra capital behind you before you jump the gun like this, because your margins are going to be tighter. But I can say with confidence that what's going to happen is you're going to get a lot more return customers, okay? So you're going to get a lot more organic sales because people do return a lot more, especially in the US, when they get fast shipping times, okay? Fulfillment centers are becoming the next big thing, really. And so it's becoming a very competitive market, which is good for us. And the products need to be purchased again from Alibaba in bulk. And you can use your sourcing agent, okay? So, you know, if your sourcing agent, you've got your sourcing agent and they've got the contract with the or dealership deal with the manufacturer, just get them to buy it, give them their piece of the pie, and get them to send them to ShipBob or FlowShip, okay? As I said, if you send it to FlowShip, you are going to get cheaper margins. You are going to get faster shipping with FlowShip than you would as well, because they're a dedicated fulfillment center. There's heaps out there. I've had people personally contact me wanting me to do it with them. But anyway, but ShipBob is definitely, if you're in the United States, you definitely want to look at trying to cut that margin, because, again, long-term over short-term, okay, guys? Again, you need to be confident, though. I just want to be honest. You need to be confident with your capital, because remember, it's not just also tighter margins, because, again, you're going to have the shipping plus fulfillment plus marketing plus taxes. There's going to be various other things that come into the equation that are going to just chew into it a bit, okay? And that's why, you know, I say 5K would work really well if you're just using a sourcing agent in China. But to the US, you probably want to look at probably around 10K. Because depending on where you are in your journey, you are going to go through 10K worth of stock pretty quick, okay? And if it takes a bit of time for the products to be shipped from China or through your supplier to the United States. It's not like 2 days. It still takes nearly about a week, okay? Sometimes, depending on various delays, it can take weeks, okay? So that's why I do recommend that before you get into this, try and do some testing, get some quotes, get some ideas, because you do need extra capital behind you and you need that bit of confidence, okay? It's scary because, you know, you can be screwed over. But that being said, because the shipping times are so quick, if your orders don't arrive for a bit, a couple of days later, you can just advise your customers simply via email to say that there has been a delay and we apologize. And if it's an extra couple of days, most people really aren't going to arc up. In fact, actually, they're going to be quite happy with that, because it's just the way business works. And the massive upside is obviously the super quick shipping, which is USPS, DHL, FedEx, I believe, resulting in far more customers, fewer chargebacks, and better reviews. So we have a look here. This is ShipBob here, just shipbob.com. And it's got a nice little video, of course, that they've made. But, you know, connect your products and send them to their store. We store your inventory. They've got, like, I think it's about 10 at least fulfillment centers across the United States. That's how they're able to get so fast. They place an order, we ship the customer fast, for blah, 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 blah. They use those shipping things. And you can see it's got a really cool, quick interface. So you can see your orders, new orders. It's basically just like Dropify and that, except just a different interface, different method, okay? Now, keep in mind, if anyone is wondering, don't worry, but all the information will be pushed back into Shopify. Shopify will then fulfill it. All the notifications on the back end will all be sent, okay? The after ship stuff will all be sent, and your customers are going to be very happy. All right, guys, so that's pretty much it from this video. I hope you did like today's video. If you did, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Ricky Hayes, IG, okay? Comment below what you would like to see in the next video, okay, guys? Thanks for your time.